Hello everyone, I am Avantika Parashar, District Museum Officer, District Museum, Jorhat. And today, on this International Museum Day, I express my warm regards and best wishes to all my friends, colleagues and those who were directly or indirectly associated with the museum field. Today, I am going to speak a little about one of our outreach activities that is called Let's Adopt a Museum. But before that, let's brief about what is there inside the District Museum, Jorhat. This museum is situated in the heart of the Jorhat city, and today, at present, it has almost 2,000 objects under its possession. We can categorize the entire collection into subcategories like numismatic, weapons, textiles, manuscripts, arm and armors, archaeological remains, everyday objects, epigraphy, etc. The time period varies from the early medieval to the late 80s and 90s, that is almost very recent. And out of the numismatic collection, we have got almost 300 coins. Some of them date back to the early medieval period, again to the Ahom era and the British era. Then we have got some very rare and very valuable manuscripts. Before going into further details, I would love to brief a little about the place Jorhat. In Assamese language, Jorhat means twin markets. It is said where the city is now today, there used to be two very important markets which used to be the lifelines of the people of that area. Again, this was the last capital of the mighty Ahom dynasty, and they fought two very significant wars from Jorhat only, and those were the Moamoria uprising and also the last Burmese invasion. Then Purandar Singh, the last Ahom ruler, he ruled his territory from Jorhat only. Again, if we move a little bit forward, then we can see this is the first place or the city where urbanization of Assam took place for the very first time. So it witnessed the amalgamation of two distinct cultural spheres, and which eventually shaped the scenario, the cultural scenario, cultural identity of our state. It has got historical significances, and they are visible from the archaeological remains that we see here in different places. We have got ponds here, temples, and all such kind of things. But apart from that, that territory, even a small cluster or a small village, has some historical evidences, some historical aspects to express from their point of view. So we can say that a single museum cannot justify the significance of the entire district. So when we were thinking from that point of view, the idea of adopting a museum came into our mind. We did some experiments and we adopted it as our educational outreach activity, and we named it Let's Adopt a Museum. Now, a little about the mechanism behind this idea. It is very simple, and it has been tried to shape it on the ideology of the new museology concept. So what we do first is that we identify a territory. It can be a village or maybe a cluster of village, but preference is that it is a rural area, not an urban area. Secondly, we go to that place, we interact with the local people, and we encourage them to develop and to build up a museum or a museum-like organization with their own effort in that particular territory. Now, there is no hard and fast rule how it has to be. There is no need to have a proper structure, proper definite museum-like structure, or to have a significant number of exhibits, or you can say a prescribed documentation format system, or conservation measures. No need of that. But they can showcase, they can exhibit anything. Maybe their own stories, the folk stories, the lullabies they have seen throughout the years, or the rural artifacts, that handicraft object, that indigenous knowledge, or any, if that something has been found, or like any everyday objects, whatever they want. But those objects which are directly associated with their way of life and through which they want to speak up some stories. So that point of view, the people, the local people, they become the custodian or the keeper of the museum, and the entire area and its different cultural components become the exhibits. That is the idea. As a school is directly associated to this process, we have also named as school museum. Our such first model museum came into existence in Piracotta of the Tiok area, that is in Jorhat. The name of the school is Mohenstor Borkotoke Higher Secondary School. We went there, we identified the place, and then we interacted with the school authority. They were very enthusiastic, and the students, when they came to know about this process from their teachers, they volunteered themselves to be associated with the museum, and they, with their own will and with the help of their family and their parents, they started donating objects to the museum. So this place, Piracotta, it is also of historical significance, because when the Ahom capital was there in Jorhat, people from the villages who comes into this area, who falls into this area, they were directly associated with the ruling system, and then the people of different professions, they used to put up in the villages near Piracotta and Tiok. And so their latest generation, that the people who are residing in those household or those villages, they were very exciting to speak up their stories, like their ancestors, their grandparents, how they, you know, used to contribute to the royal people, how they used to work with the royal family. So such stories came up. It was very interesting to, or very informative to interact with the local people, and even the very elderly generation, like above 80 or one or two person nearing 90, they came to meet us and to talk their stories. It has been almost 2 years since the establishment of the school museum, and it's running successfully. Now the students, they are actually curating the entire museum, because if some people or some tourists go to that place, of course people go because there is a historical pond or some historical temples nearing to that area. So if some people go, then the students themselves volunteer to speak about the collections of that small museum. So what is there inside the museum? There are a few coins. And then again, this is a very rich in agricultural output. So it has displayed almost 50 to 60 varieties of paddies, different varieties they have exhibited there. Then they have also displayed the indigenous tools associated with the weaving process and also with the sericulture process. So in that way, that the collection, it is such an interesting collection, and the associated stories, they are so interesting, and most importantly, the enthusiasm that is visible in the effort of the school authority and the local people, the guardian and the students. It's so interesting that we have now assumed that this effort, the first model, is successful. Now, Jorhat District Museum is planning to extend it forward, and we are thinking of establishing our next model school museum under the Let's Adopt a Museum initiative. And for that purpose, we have identified the Nimati area. It's near the Brahmaputra River, and we are developing the modules how to come up with the idea and how to execute it. District Museum Jorhat is very happy to say that Let's Adopt a Museum campaign, its first module, is a success, because we started it as an outreach activity. Now we have achieved the outcome what we have aimed for. Firstly, that's the entire population of a definite territory, they have been engaged in the process. Secondly, they have become their custodian and the keeper of that museum, if we can say a school museum or a model museum or territory museum, whatever it is, they have become the custodian. They have developed the museum, and they are now looking after the museum with their own effort for almost 2 years. So we are thinking that we will expand this process, and we'll, in the later phases, we'll try to cover up more, at least two or three places, two or three territories in a year, and we just hope that we will success and we will keep people engaging in the heritage sanitization process. Thank you.